and gentlemen, in the unlikely event of the fire alarm being activated, please exit the building using one of the fire exits inside, form up on the assembly point at the rear of Exchange Bikes. Please ensure all mobile phones are switched off.
Thank you very much. Could I now invite nominations for the office of Lord Mayor for 2015-2016? Mayor Anderson.
Lord Mayor, can I move that Councillor Anthony Conception would be the full title? Anthony Conception being elected Lord Mayor for the ensuing year 2015-2016. Lord Mayor, I'm somewhat sort of touched by the honour of nominating Tommy. We've been really close friends for many, many years. Indeed, it's fair to say that probably we could be called the Dingle Mafia in terms of. And what's going to happen, I think, is probably unprecedented and known in the history of the council. We're going to have an elected mayor, of course, me, who's a St. Vinny's old boy, and a St. Martin's old boy. And a Lord Mayor is a St. Vinny's old boy and a St. Martin's old boy. We know actually who is the older of the two of us, but of course we've mentioned that. So it's a great honour and privilege for St. Vinny's and St. Martin's to be associated with both of us, I'm sure. And I will remind all the governors and teachers and kids as I visit St. Vinny's that we've now got, I'm sure you'll visit them yourself. But I remember when Tony was a councillor before he was re-elected again. It was the year that I was elected in 1998. And Tony was defeated, he represented Dovecot at that time. I'm sorry to dwell a little bit on that, but it was a great day of sadness for you, not only because you lost Dovecot, but you were that day very young. And I remember how hard it hit you. And you were very much in my thoughts and my prayers and my mind on that particular day. And we met lots of times on lots of occasions and functions and different things. And I said, you'd bounce back. So, you know, to me, this is great and fitting tribute to you to show that you have indeed bounced back. You're one of the loyal and best servants this city has ever had in the roles that you played previously to your re-election, and I'm sure you're going to serve as first citizen of Liverpool with real distinction, and I'm looking forward to working alongside you and you representing our city as first citizen. So it gives me, as I said, tremendous pleasure and a real honour to nominate you, as I said, my close friend, but somebody I know has got the loyalty and passion for our city that many people would only have a fraction of. So good luck for the ensuing year. I'm delighted on behalf of your colleagues and your friends to be given the privilege to nominate you as Lord Mayor for 2015-2016.
And can I ask if that motion is seconded, Councillor Crowe? Yes. Yeah. Do you want to say a few words?
Thank you, Lord Mayor. I haven't actually had the good fortune to meet Tony Anthony Conception personally, so I did ask a few people who have met Anthony. And Royal Council is an extremely highly respected councillor and a very well-liked person, so I think they're an excellent job representing Liverpool. And look forward to chairing these meetings with aplomb. Thanks.
Councillor Kemp?
My Lord Mayor, I too was going to start roughly at the same time as the elected mayor of Liverpool. It seems a bit like Sunday, doesn't it? In all the years I've known your tone, I've never heard you called Anthony before. And then Mayor Anderson starts talking about all these saints as well, so perhaps we're all going to be blessed today by your presence as Lord Mayor. I remember well your previous service before 1998, when you were a very hard-working chair of the Planning Committee. You had very strong and hard opinions about planning, And so did I. Unfortunately, those opinions didn't always coincide. So we agreed to disagree honourably, and I would certainly share with the Mayor of Liverpool today the comment that he made about you being a true servant of this city. Yes, I can have political disagreements with you, as I do many other people here, but no one has ever doubted that your first concern is the people of Liverpool and this city as a whole. And I am sure that you will make an excellent Lord Mayor for this city, and I have great pleasure in supporting your nomination.
Well, I was reflecting on the way down, and in many ways it shows how much the politics of the city has changed. When we were first involved, I remember the Labour Group campaigning to abolish the position of Lord Mayor as being feudalistic capitalism at its worst and should be abolished. And we were having debates on that front and how politics have changed. We used to have 99 councillors then, and we had a very different flavour of politics then. And I think your journey, our journey, reflects the way the city's had to adapt to different circumstances and different attitudes and different experiments. And we've got now a Labour Party now very much representing entrepreneurial a view of politics and local government, a totally different contrast. On a personal basis, I really had the pleasure already of seeing you in your action in your one step removed from the mayor, because you took the great opportunity to visit one of our congregations in Chibok. You really made yourself inquisitive, I think, to put it the best way. You went out and you were meeting everybody, you were trying to know about that denomination, which wasn't one of the mainstream denominations, and you really showed a lot of personal interest. That was very, very noticeable, and I think you really showed you the flavour of doing the role already. So I wish you well. Like Councillor Kemp, we're on the planning committee, and we often clash, I think probably more often than most, but that's healthy. I think actually that's one of the healthy things about local government, that we can disagree with each other about a political issue and still have civil respect. So I wish you well. I wish your family, just as importantly, well in supporting you in the role. I can see you've got a full turnout to enjoy the occasion, and I'm sure you'll have very much respect. So I wish you my best and best on behalf of myself and all your group.
Slight worrying moment for you here. Are there any other nominations, Lord Mayor? No? In that case, I'll put the nomination of Councillor Anthony Conception to the Council for Lord Mayor. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Right, well done. So, you the dice.
I, Councillor Anthony Conception, having been elected to the office of Lord Mayor of the City of Liverpool, declare that I take the office upon myself and will duly and faithfully fulfil the duties of it according to the best of my judgment and ability. I undertake to observe the code of conduct which is expected of members of the City Council. Thank you. Bear with me for a moment. Right, my first duty upon taking the role of the Lord Mayor is actually to thank the outgoing Lord Mayor, Councillor Erica Kemp. Erica, I'm sure I speak for the whole chamber when I say you have been a wonderful ambassador for our city. Over the last 12 months, you have worked very hard, attending over 900 engagements, attending 7 royal visits, and working tirelessly on behalf of your chosen charities, the Alzheimer's Society, SAFA, the Teenage Cancer Trust, and the Reader Organisation. During your year of office, you have done a fantastic job. You have used the role of Liverpool's First Citizen to reach out to all sections of our great city. Your passion, support, and encouragement to volunteers and community groups has been inspirational. I know encouraging people to get involved is something that you care deeply about. Developing reading skills, so essential for our young people, is a passion that you have championed. The unsung work of countless volunteers who get little mention for all their hard work and can sometimes go unnoticed is something that you have sought to recognise and help to change. I know your highlights of your year are too numerous to mention, but the Return of the Giants, Memories of August 1914, are special memories for you. And the celebration of the Cunard's Three Queens at the weekend is something that you will treasure forever. And I think, like many people in our city, it was a wonderful occasion and a spectacle that we should really be proud of. And not to mayor, forget your CBE and the New Year's Honours List, so richly deserved. Your commitment to building a caring, friendly and warm, inclusive city is something that you can be justly proud of and a fitting legacy that I hope to build on. On a personal level, I would just like to thank you so much for all the kind words and friendly advice in supporting me as your deputy. It's really been a privilege. In particular, your introductions and invitations to civic events has really been helpful and given me the confidence and understanding to take on this important role, and I will be eternally grateful. Thank you so much. You've been wonderful.
Congratulations. Can I just say, very briefly, today is a very, very special day for you and Anne, and I hope you're going to thoroughly enjoy every minute of it. I am sure you're going to have a fantastic year, and I look forward to picking up the Echo and thinking, wish I'd been invited to that event, or, oh, that was a good event, I'm so pleased. I really will be following both your progress with much interest and a real genuine thrill for you. And to your family, can I say, be proud, be very, very proud today of our new Lord Mayor and the Lady Mayoress. It's not an easy year. And there'll be times when they'll be very, very busy and they'll need you to look after them. Tonight, at the dinner, when the new Lord Mayor and the Lady Mayoress are announced in, will you stand up and give them the biggest, loudest round of applause that any Lord Mayor has ever had at any dinner to wish them well on their journey for the next year and to give them a really very precious memory that will last them for the rest of their lives. Good luck.
Fond memories of your time in the town of the world, as well as just kind of
just like to thank, starting off on my speech, Mayor Anderson, Councillor Crowe, Councillor Radford, Councillor Kent for all their kind words. Indeed, I've known Joe for many, many years, and those words that he talked about St. Vincent's ring a bell with me, obviously. Friends, family and colleagues, I'm really thrilled and excited and deeply honoured to be installed as the next Lord Mayor of Liverpool. In fact, I've been pinching myself all day to think if it's real. And I think I'll testify to that, you know. We have been sort of up the wall this morning, looking after the grandkids and the little dog that my daughter has just been at. But anyway, once again, I'd like to thank Erica and Rachel for all their hard work during this year. You've been fine ambassadors for our city, and I think we all appreciate it. I would also like to thank the Town Hall staff, who have been an enormous source of help and support in preparing me for this important position. They have guided me through the role and protocol of being the Lord Mayor, step by step, and prepared me for this important role. I'm very grateful also for the democratic services who make everything tick and run smoothly, especially at full council. And I'm sure that they will continue to provide the professionalism and the expertise that I will need in the 12 months in the future. And to my colleagues, Councillor John Prince and Councillor Barbara Murray, and the always say Team Utrecht, for all their support and hard work for me this year, and I'm sure they'll even add more work this coming year as I take on additional duties. Also, to some of the community groups and volunteers in Utrecht, some who are here tonight, who really work hard in the community to improve our community. And my friends and colleagues from West Derby, I'd just like to say a big, big thank you to all your help and support over the years. As you can imagine, today is a really big day for me, my family, the ward I represent, Utrecht, and the community where I live, which is in Otty Ash in West Derby. And I'm eternally grateful to the Mayor and the City Council for the opportunity to represent this great city. As Joe said, I don't have the Dingle Mafia. My brother would always say, we were born in Liverpool 1, you know. He keeps me, I'm not the retail district, I hasten to that. But it was a thriving community in the parish of St. Peter's, in the centre of the city. And I live round the corner from St. Luke's, top of Bold Street. Not the bombed out church that, you know, it's frequently referred to, but it's a war memorial dedicated to the memory of all those people who lost their lives during the Second World War. And I'm really glad that work is underway to restore and preserve this important building for the future generations to visit and to enjoy its tranquil surroundings. My mother was a big influence on me. She was a single mother, struggling to bring up 5 children on her own after my father died when I was just 2. Growing up, I remember her struggling 3 jobs, weekly trips to the washhouse of Upper Frederick Street. That was the first one in Liverpool and in the country, founded by another famous Liverpool woman, Kitty Wilkinson. All my brothers had jobs after school, helping out with the family finances. But me and my sister had a more normal, carefree childhood. We, like many families at the time, were poor, but we always found strength in our family and the wider community. Something I believe is just as true today as it was then. I particularly remember every Christmas, my mother would put up a red star in the window of our house in Roscoe Lane. And you could see it clearly at night when walking up Renshaw Street. It shone like a beacon in the night to welcome us home. My wife Anne, who I met when I was 16, and has stood by me through thick and thin, has been my rock throughout my life. We met on the Royal Iris, another Liverpool icon, on a river cruise, and I do remember Lulu was top of the bill. And we will shortly celebrate our 46th wedding anniversary in June. And we've actually lived in Notty Ash all our married life. And Anne, I just want to thank you for everything you do, for being there and putting up with me and my beliefs. But I know that you will be a great Lady Mayoress and a real success as Liverpool's First Lady. To my children. Tony and Louise, who I'm immensely proud of, their partners Mark and Michael, and my grandkids Maisie and Miles, who were so important in our lives and remind me why I first got involved in politics. A better future for everyone. I think we all share that ambition. Miles in particular has been counting down the days of when I become Lord Mayor, and he's even perfected a special bow, which really puts me in my place because it's normally accompanied with a big raspberry. But my mother, who instilled in me the virtues of honesty, trust and sense of family, is something I hold dear and cherish today. I've been active in politics all my life, as my wife will readily testify. I was first elected to the City Council in 1990. Actually, Joe, it was for the old Broad Green ward. And it was the year of the poll tax. And what sticks in my mind was the turbulent politics of the time. From 1992 to 96, there was no overall control. There were many heated debates in this chamber. There were divisions, splits, walkouts, caucuses. Different factions abounded. And that was only in the Labour group. But Liverpool, in my opinion, is unique. Political sands can change very quickly here. And after 18 years in the wilderness, the Labour government was elected in 1997. But in Liverpool the following year, we actually lost control of the council when I and many other colleagues lost our seats. And it was 12 years before I returned to the council as a member for Ewtree Ward. And it wasn't for the lack of trying, because I did try quite a lot of time. But like you all, I came into public life to make a difference, to help people and be a voice for the very community that elects you. And I do hope I've been able to achieve that. And I can only feel pretty humble that I've been chosen to be Liverpool's first citizen. The late John Smith, that great Labour leader, once said, "All I ask is the opportunity to serve." Now, not for a minute could I compare myself to him. But the opportunity to serve is something I hold dear. To serve our great city, to promote its strength, to highlight its success, to welcome our guests, to celebrate our achievements, to serve our community, is something I will always strive to achieve. My theme during the year of office will be to celebrate diversity in the city. As you can imagine, with a name like mine, my grandfather wasn't born in the UK. He was a merchant seaman from a more exotic climes. My mother's family came from Ireland, so in many ways I consider myself a product of the melting pot that Liverpool was and continues to be today. Our great city to me is a beacon of light, a bit like the light that shone brightly in my old house, welcoming people home. It's a city of diversity, tolerance and racial harmony, a friendly city full of talented people with a unique sense of humour and a waterfront known the world over. But given our history, I know that we can't take this for granted. We must always strive to tackle discrimination and promote equality wherever we can. This year I've chosen three charities. Ronald McDonald House at Alderhay, the house that love built, a special caring home where families of seriously ill children receiving treatment at Alderhay can stay without charge. Funded entirely by voluntary contributions, a home from home for families dealing with traumatic and stressful situations. KIND, founded in 1975 and celebrating its 40th anniversary. KIND helps children and their families from across Liverpool and Merseyside to overcome disadvantage, to inspire and to empower them, to develop their skills, improve their self-confidence and reach their full potential. And Lister Steps, founded by local residents in 1997, they aim to make their neighbourhood Tobruk an attractive and sought-after place to live where businesses flourish and people's lives are enriched and ambitions achieved. They have exciting plans to create a hub of community services from the former Grade 2 listed Andrew Carnegie Library Building. All my sponsored charities are focused on helping children and families cope with difficult and developing community engagement. But Liverpool has had a proud history of helping our fellow citizens in difficult times. So please support these three fantastic charities that will make a real difference to people's lives. Well, thank you very much for listening. Thank you. Short break now, so can I just invite my guests to go to the small ballroom and we'll resume in about 15 minutes. So it sounds like a short break. Oh no, sorry. I forgot, haven't I? Already. That's my break. Sorry about that. Could I? Obviously, I've got a. I'm learning anyway, so I'm sure it'll be the first of many, but can I just call for nominations for the role of Deputy Lord Mayor?
Lord Mayor, can I move the nomination of Councillor Ros Gladden to act as Deputy Mayor for the ensuing year, 2015-2016?
I'm happy to second the nomination of Ros Gladden.
Are there any other nominations? No. Is that agreed?
I undertake to observe the code of conduct which is expected of members of the City Council.
I did get a bit ahead of myself there, I really apologise for that, but can we all just welcome Councillor Ros Gladden as a Deputy Lord Mayor. And now can I ask Anne to come to the front, and Rachel is going to present the chain of office. Now I can ask people to adjourn the meeting for 15 minutes and for my guests to go to the small ballroom. And we'll see you back in the show in about 15 minutes. Thank you.